to personally go through almost 10,000 pictures and movies and memorabilia, very personal things, very historical things from all of you and from this town. I mean, it's an incredible honor. And I've also gotten to spend time with kids in the elementary and middle schools here. I met with them and had them do drawings or bring in things related to what was important to them about Chapel Hill. I got to watch them create these amazing drawings that you'll see in the artwork, and work with the teachers to explain what public art is to some of the kids here. I was taken around town by so many generous people to get barbecue, to get BLTs, to get beer.
Where's your favorite place?
I've been here a week now for the installation, and I've made a point of trying to hit all the places I've learned about or had been to on previous visits. So I can't say I have a favorite, but I have a couple more I'm going to go to before I leave. So it's been incredible. I've gotten to listen to music from here. I've gotten to revisit music that was important to me when I was growing up, that came from this town. So all these amazing things I've gotten to be a part of, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate that and how meaningful it is to me to play a part in not only the artwork but the town. Now, as an artist that works in doing public art around the country, in a lot of ways, this project is, for me, an example of public art at its best, because it started with an idea, a concept that I presented to the committee, which was the idea of Unbound, that a library binds together all these things and keeps them safe, but then releases them out into the community and unbinds them by making them available. So we started with that, and originally I thought this artwork would be filled with all these different things from the library, from the books and the movies and the images on the shelves here. But in meeting with and working with the Public Art Committee and with the Public Art staff and with Susan and the librarians here, we realized that there was a way to make it a bigger thing that was more about the community itself. And that's the fact that this piece really is about Chapel Hill, not only because all the images are from here, but also because the whole concept developed because I was working with the Public Art Committee and the librarians. So it really is special because of that, and this couldn't exist anywhere else. So what you're gonna see here are almost 10,000 pieces of media in all these different lenses that we're gonna see in a few minutes. So many things were contributed by you guys. You sent them in to me, or I collected them from the Historical Society and many other generous organizations, individuals that sent in their artwork, things from their businesses. There's a gentleman here, Jordan, who drove from two and a half hours. Yeah. He does aerial photography of Chapel Hill. I found it online and contacted him to see if I could include it. He came down 2.5 hours to the opening. Anyway, so many people were very generous. You may not see the thing that you submitted if you submitted something tonight, because it's all randomized. You don't know when stuff is going to come up. Sometimes it comes up based on subject matter. It could be color, it could be about UNC, it could be about art or sports. Sometimes it's all randomized. But if you don't see what you contributed, come back again. Maybe you'll see it next time. But what you will see is something that someone else from this community submitted. And that's, to me, an important part of this, because you're going to see they're all things that are important to you and others that you share this community with. So to me, that's one of the special things about it. You may not see what you sent in. You may not see the picture of your dog or your son or your daughter, but you're going to see someone else's, and you realize it's there because that was important to them. So anyway, I guess I'll just finish up by thanking everyone for all your help. Susan and the library staff, Jeff and Steve and the public art staff and committee, and everyone in town who helped make this what it is. It's an honor.